guys, I'm Manpreet and today I'm going to review the second book by this author, Savi Sharma. This is not your story. Now, my history with this author is Everyone Has a Story was a book that I didn't like. I have already done the review, which is linked down below. But I'm a person who does not judge an author because of one book he or she has written. So this book is something which I'll consider as a standalone because it's not a part of series after all. So I'm going to discuss the plot, narration and characters of this book and whether this book is worth reading or not according to me. The story of the book is about three people: Shaurya, who is a CA student and who wants to follow his dreams; Anubhav, who is an entrepreneur and who is already following his dreams; and Miraya, who is an interior designer, and it's about her will to live a life again in a manner. The back cover of the book says that this is a story about following Shaurya's dreams. This is a story about believing in love, which goes for Miraya, and this is a story about giving life another chance, which goes for Anubhav. Now, without further ado, let's get started with this video and let's see what I think about it. Before that, I would like to say that we have already done a book discussion for a book club about this book, and to be honest, when I started that book discussion, I had like better ratings for this book, and my ratings after that book discussion have reduced. Now, there's a very big reason about it. I could really connect to this character who wanted to be a filmmaker, and he was, you know, he was too scared to take that first step and everything like that. This book is mainly about Shaurya and his fear within, which is stopping him from following his dreams. I could very much relate to this character for a lot of reasons because I am into this field, I have been through it, I know how it feels like, you know, to be afraid yourself about your dreams because, you know, there is so much of uncertainty around you because of that, and that's why I could really connect to Shaurya, and I was like, you know, I love this book because of that reason. But as I went on with the book discussion, I figured out that there are a lot of problems with this book as well, and I'm gonna just focus on all these things which we discussed and all these things which I feel, so that you can make your own decision about reading this book or not, right? I think we should start with characters this time, and I told you already that I loved Shaurya as a character and the whole part of Shaurya in this book. Then there is Miraya, who comes to this place called Jaipur, and she is having this mystery all around her, and there is something about her that she's hiding and she doesn't want to talk about, and you know, she doesn't believe in love for a lot of different reasons, and it's about what happens with her so that, you know, she changes her perspective. It's about her believing in love again, as already said on the back cover. As a character, I felt like Miraya was pretty good character after Shaurya. She didn't have a big role in the book, but I really loved how detailed this character was, in the sense that she's an interior designer, and when she goes somewhere, she actually sees that place from the lens of an interior designer, which I think was very, very cool and very thoughtful from this author. Then there is Anubhav. Now, Anubhav is a character we all like almost hated in the book discussion because of the fact that Anubhav, in the first part of the book, you'll be like, why this character is even here, and in the last part of the book, you are still feeling like, you know, he has been pushed into the story. I, however, related Anubhav to this another thing which I thought this book was about. So I kind of liked it, but we have mixed opinion about it because of that fact, because it does feel like, you know, why is this guy even there? So overall, there is another character who has a very minuscule role in the book, and I really loved her for that minuscule role. That's like something I like. If you're not going to give a big role to the character, give her a small role that will make people remember her or him. Let's move on to the writing style of the author, which I always say that is beautiful. I really loved how she writes. I really, you know, it's like everything is so quotable, everything is like amazing when it comes to her writing style. But at the same time, we have to talk about the plot as well, which is again a bit weak. Now, the book is just about, you know, like, I don't know. This book was just about, first of all, I really had a problem with the way this name was pushed into the story. At this moment, suddenly everybody is like, this is not your story, this is not your story, this is not your story. And I'm like, what is happening? So that was like pushed into the story. And moreover, there is not something amazing happening around the story. There's this guy who wants to follow his dream, he cannot. There's this girl who really needs a change in her life. And there's this guy who follows his dream, and then everything goes wrong. There's nothing amazing about the story. It's simple, it's okay. And yes, you may or may not enjoy it because of that fact. If you like really simple, okay stories which, you know, which are written well, you would like this book. Otherwise, My overall ratings for this book now would be 3 out of 5. I always change my ratings according to how I feel about the book at particular points of time, and by the time I do review, my ratings have changed at least 1-2 times. So this book's final ratings are 3 out of 5 because of the fact that I really liked, you know, the simple plot as well, but the plot could have been much more interesting. I liked Shaurya as a character, but I didn't like other characters. I like how she writes, so I gave it 3 out of 5 stars, which truly means that read at your own risk. Yeah. So this is my review for This Is Not Your Story. I definitely feel like that there are much better books, much more inspiring books out there that you can read and get your inspiration from. Your time is precious, so I would really like you to spend your time on some great books. And this is not one of them. This is just one normal book. If you want to read it, do read it. If you don't want to read it, don't ever feel guilty about not picking up this book. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. I know a lot of you have already read this book, and I am hoping that all of you have already read this book but were not in the book discussion. Would leave your comments on below about what you think about this book and what you think about the plot, characters and writing style. I'm really looking forward to hear back from you guys. Thank you so much for watching this video. This is Nanvi signing off. I'll be back with another video very soon.